is it not written in your law that ye are gods? You understand what I'm saying? So it just depends on what level you own based on, whether you're human or whether you're immortal.
At ease. It's your boy, Soul Immortal. Before I even start, I want to give a shout out to a young brother named Preezy the Kid. I believe he may have just started his YouTube channel pretty recently. And he made a video and he put me in the top five, or his top five of influencers in the manosphere, right? So I appreciate it. I also thank Amber over at the Holistic Temple for sending me that video this morning. Well, today's question comes from a brother named AT, right, on my Patreon channel. And AT says, what's up, bro? What is confidence and how can a person master it? I'm 21, so that question might sound young. Now, brother, I know that that question may seem like it would only come from a young, you know, inexperienced man. But I'm telling you, brother, there are men that are my age, which is 44, that still can't give you the answer to that question, right? Matter of fact, there are men that are twice my age that still don't know the answer to that question, right? But to get to the bottom of it, to answer your question, brother, we first have to identify what a man looks like that doesn't have confidence. So identifying a man that lacks confidence in this society is very simple, right? You know, first you can look at men in relationships. You know, the type of men that are very indecisive, you know, these are the men that lack confidence. The guys that have to get, you know, their wives' approval to make dinner plans, to go to the movies, you know, to make a quick getaway trip. The ones that have to get the green light from their spouse, these are normally your men that lack confidence. They lack that ability, you know, to make command decisions or to quarterback in a relationship, right? Now, you can also see these men in their career path, right? You see several of these men at work. These are the guys that are typically just yes men. You know, what these guys don't understand is that they can only elevate so high in their career because at some point in time, an organization is going to require a man that can make a firm decision. You know, the type of men that can make a command decision and ask for forgiveness later if need be, right? And even when it comes to, like, dating, you know, your single, you know, man that lacks confidence, this is the guy that can see a woman that he's highly attracted to, but still fails to have that umph, that thing inside of him that gives him the courage to go in and approach this woman, right? Now, here's the thing. At some point, these young men get frustrated with being in this energy. At some point in time, they get tired of being this type of man. So what do? They go into observation mode. In other words, they start looking at the world around them to find out what confidence is, right? So, you know, they're out and about and they see the man pull up in the foreign whip. You know, this guy gets out, man, he's walking like he's on top of the world. And a young man looks at this guy and says, you know what? That's confidence. So he says, you know what? What I need to do is get me a bad ride and then I'll be confident, right? You know, he's out and about on the weekends and he might see a man with what, you know, society calls a 10. And he says, you know what? That's it. Like, I need to get me a baddie just like that one and then I'll find confidence. You know, he goes home on the weekends and he's watching his music videos and he's seeing the guys in the Balenci's, he's seeing the Gucci belts, he's seeing the guy count money on his own, right? And he says, that's it. He said, I need to get the bag and then I'll have confidence. But this is where most men get it wrong. So you have to understand something, brothers. Some of these men that you see are actually confident, but a large number of these guys are just feeling themselves, right? And it's important that you know the difference, but you know, because it's gonna determine how you move in the future. You know what I'm saying? So I know you're asking the question like, well, what's the difference between a guy that's actually confident and the man that's just feeling himself, right? See, the man that's confident, he actually knows himself, right? Whereas the guy that's feeling himself, you know, he's defined by either his things or his success. Now I'm gonna say that again, guys. The guy that's actually confident, he knows himself. He believes in himself, right? Whereas the guy that's just feeling himself, He's defined by the things that he's accumulated, or he's defined by his success. Now, this is one of the very first lessons I taught my son, right? So my son is 13 years old. He'll be 14 this year, right? And he started rocking, his shoe game, went to another level. I guess when he turned around 10 or 11 years old, right? And I can remember when he first got his first pair of, dope shoes. There was some LeBrons, right? And I remember he got these shoes. He wanted them. He got them. And I was in my office, and he came downstairs that next morning for school, and he was a whole different person, right? I'm talking about a whole different cat coming out just shoulder low, walking with a little lean. He's looking down at his shoes, because he want to see him move. You know what I'm saying? Whole different cat. And I'm in my office, and I'm observing this. So I said, son, come in, have a sit down. Let's chop it up for a minute. And he's like, well, Dad, I'm gonna miss the bus. I'm like, well, son, what I'm about to teach you right now is far more valuable than what they're gonna teach you down at the institution. So just hold tight, right? So I said, this is the thing. I said, when you rock these shoes, whether you're getting the LeBrons or the Jordans or the Yeezys, whatever you rock, you can't let these shoes make you. I said, you need to have the exact same energy when you rock these shoes that you have when you rocking your $10 flip-flops to school, right? You need to have that exact same energy, because if you don't, what you're telling me, what you're telling the world is that this product is what made me who I am. What you're telling me is that the reason I walk with a lean, the reason I'm dope today is because I got this product on, where it needs to be the opposite. I said, these people should be proud that you are rocking a product. So again, have that exact same energy that you have when you rocking the no-names. You know what I'm saying? And what this started to do, it started to build his confidence. Because then he got to the point where he's like, What I know who I am now, and if this shoe isn't making me, then it's automatically, building his character up, right? So some days he might rock the J's, he might rock the Yee or whatever he's rocking, but some days he can just rock some flip-flops because he understands now that the shoes don't make him, right? Now, the reason I taught him this is because it's important that he knows the difference, because this is what he's going to see in society as he grows up, right? Imagine... Let's say you have a friend, right? And your friend just all of a sudden hits a lick. And when I say hit a lick, meaning, he just got a new job, he got a promotion, he got a settlement. In some way or shape, your brother just came into some money, right? Now, let's say your boy pulls up and he G-wagging the next day. He winning, right? There's nothing wrong with that guy. That's a good thing. But let's say he hops out the G-wagon and all of a sudden he's a whole different cat. That right there lets you know that he's just feeling himself. And that he really isn't a confident guy. Because it's like, all this newfound energy. Like, where was this person when you were pushing the Ford Escort last week? You know what I'm saying? Where was this energy at? I'm going to tell you this, guys. The quickest way to know if a man is truly confident is let him lose everything he has, right? Let him lose the cars. Let him lose the job. Let him lose the money. And if he's a confident man, his energy is going to be the exact same as it was when he had it, right? When a brother loses everything, it's like, where's that energy at? It's like, where's that swag? It's like, why is that walk different today than it was yesterday? Again, that's letting you know that he didn't have confidence, that he was only feeling himself. So to answer your question, brother, what is confidence and how do you master it? It's simple. You first have to understand that confidence is when a man can separate himself from the world. And what I mean by that is when a man can set his own standards, right? When a man can separate himself from the standards and ways of the world. Not only separate himself from the ways and the standards of the world, but now these things can no longer, be used to identify who he is, right? And to master that thing, it's simply a matter of continuously finding self, and elevating in that area, right? See, when it comes to the clothes and the cars and the belts and all this stuff, this stuff is not bad. It becomes bad when it's used to define a man, right? Even when it comes to a woman, one thing that men need to do is be comfortable with approaching any woman. They also need to be comfortable with approaching a woman that they desire and not what society has said is a 10. And I'm not going to go far in that because I want to go full into that on one of my next videos, right? Ultimately, guys, confidence is when a man knows who he is, he knows what he is and what he's capable of, and he doesn't give a damn what anybody else thinks about it.